Balance? Balance? What does balance have to do with gains? Boom! Boom! What's up, everyone? Mark Lobiner, TigerFitness.com, CEO! MTS Nutrition. Steve Shaw, our editorial director for TigerFitness.com, sent me over an amazing article today. And he said, I know you're gonna love this. Steve Shaw knows my thoughts on unilateral training, my thoughts on training one leg at a time or one arm at a time, as you guys see in my 12-week trainer, my Exos training-based, hypertrophy and functional-based trainer, linked down below. As you guys know, I absolutely love single arm movements that make you balance yourself with your core. I also love movements that activate your core. It's the best way to, have you ever held your hands over your head, right? Held what? Weight over your head? What happens? Well, you're activating your core, right? You're activating the shit out of your core. So, get hot when I talk. What happens when you do a hex bar deadlift? You pick it up, boom, core's engaged, or else you're gonna have bad issues. Forces it out, Valsalva maneuver pushes out, that makes your internal belt, I like to call it. Squats, you're here, boom, chest is out, breathe in, abdominals are activated, it's all activated. Single leg movements allow you to do many things. The way I organize my workouts, I usually start with movement prep. You guys have seen my article, I'll go ahead and post it down below the 12-week trainer link. My movement prep generally takes 25 to 30 minutes. My movement prep has things such as mini bands or seven-way hip. My movement prep has things such as world greatest stretch, has things such as the inchworm or the walkouts as you want to call them. It can even have plyos. I'll usually do things like for back day, since I'm doing deadlifts and I'm doing upper body, I will do a pec deck to get the antagonist going. I will do, or a press, I will do some kind of unilateral pull down on the lat pull down machine, just two sets of 10 light reps. And then I'll do leg extensions, leg curls to make sure that those muscles are activated. That's called movement prep. I basically took what they do for athletes, translated it into hypertrophy training. So my workout starts with movement prep. After movement prep, I'll do a heavy compound. For example, yesterday I did heavy ass dumbbell press, right? So heavy dumbbell press, but then today I did barbell rows, really heavy. I went up to 405, rested on the ground, pull it up. I believe they're called Pendlay rows. I'm not sure. For some reason, I'm blanking on that. And then after that, I did trap bar deadlifts. After that, I did unilateral. One was unsupported one arm row with 150s. I worked up to 150 pound dumbbells. And then I did other unilateral or ancillary training. So my belief is you use your heavy compound, whether you're an athlete or not. For example, when I train my daughter, you guys have seen that on my Instagram. You've seen that on the Ghetto channel, youtube.com/Lobiner. My daughter does, so are my daughter and my son. What they'll do is they'll do something. For example, yesterday we did goblet squats. There's your compound movement. After goblet squats, we did single leg pistol squats. We did split squats. And then we do single leg Romanian deadlift. And the reason is for athletes to fix those imbalances to prevent injury, you want to make sure to unilateral it. Now, a lot of benefits to unilateral. Number one is it helps to fix imbalances. A lot of people say, oh, one lat's bigger than the other, one lat can contract. By putting all your mental focus into one lat, if you're, let's say you're a bodybuilder, you want to flex. If you're used to pulling down and focusing on that one lat rather than both together, when you end up coming forward and you hit that front double, whew, front lat spread, you're able to consciously, again, flexing and any athletic movement is repetition. Repetition. It took me thousands of repetitions to get that pose right. And I'm still not perfect. The best posers usually practice a lot, unless you're Dexter Jackson. So by doing that, it allows you to mimic it. If you're an athlete, by being on one leg, the reason I like one leg plyometrics on one leg lateral is because one, it helps stabilize your knee because your muscles are used to engaging. And if you're on the field, you'll know what to do because it's a repetitive motion. It becomes part of your brain's mechanism of working. So obviously fix imbalances. Again, another thing is it works more muscles. A lot of people say, well, there's not a lot of overload when they see me do single leg Romanian deadlifts. Use same arm, same leg, right arm, right leg. This arm's the free arm, this leg straighten up, come down, and come up. That'll be a single leg Romanian deadlift. Like, well, you're not overloading much. Yeah, but when you're doing that lift, imagine, just to not fall, you're not just coming here where you're on the ground and bending. That's going, okay, that is overloading your hamstrings. But to keep from to keep your balance, you have to basically recruit your abductors, your adductors, your gluteus, and of course your core. They all have to work in concert to get things to working, to work. So in sport, like again, so if for hypertrophy, even more so, for years been recommending start with the powerlifting move, be it a squat, deadlift, bench, or overhead press, right? After that, what do? Well, you're gonna do some other things. I don't like to see, like let's say if you do bench one day, I don't see a need to do more incline. Chest is chest. You don't have an upper chest, lower chest, and middle chest. You have your fucking pectoralis major and pectoralis minor, whatever. You don't have to work, do two different presses. So from there, you do your flies. I like flies. You know, one can argue for or against flies all day. I like them, I do them. I find that they really recruit some different kind of fibers. But what if you were to do an uneven bench press? If you go to my trainer, click on the link below, you'll see, if you're off the bench, you come down, you come up, you have half your body off the bench, you're engaging everything, including more of your pec than you've ever engaged before. Now, in another article, there's gonna be three links down below. In the third one, that'll be Steve Shaw's article that he put out about unilateral leg training. Now that is a leg training article and it's all unilateral. Now the beauty of that is if you are having back issues, you can actually load your muscle with more weight without putting extra weight on your spine. For example, if you're doing 225 on squat, you'll probably be able to single leg press or some similar movement. Let's say leg press, you're doing a 500 pounds on leg press. You'll be a little bit stronger with one leg because of the neural recruitment. One leg is usually stronger than both. Pound, you know, basically you'll do more than half. So if you're doing 500, let's say you do 300 pounds with a single leg leg press. That is 200 less pounds of load on your joints, on your body and all that. So what that does for your lower back, it allows you to overload it with less load on the body and spine. So again, there are benefits to that and lunges, for example, if you're squatting, you know, if you're squatting 300 pounds and you're single leg lunging 135, just in perspective, that's less load, but you're still getting that muscular recruitment. So I highly recommend reading the article. Three articles below. One is the trainer. If you haven't got it yet, download it. It's worth reading. Even if you don't follow it, I think you'll learn a lot. You'll also find some new exercises you might have never done. There's a video for every movement. There's a video for every day. It took me a long time and a lot of money to get this done. All right, so check that out. There's gonna be an article on movement prep, which I recommend you do. And of course, the article on unilateral leg training. Huge fan of unilateral. I could talk about this for another 12 hours. Go ahead, check it out. Click on the link down below. It just might be your ticket to pain-free gains and functional strength. I'm Mark Lobliner, TigerFitness.com, because unilateral leg training, and that's not a game.